Yeah, baby. Welcome back. This is Chapparal, part 8 on Slick Shifts. I'm Mac. Let's get after it. So if you guys have been watching the video series, like I hope you've been watching, I've pretty much been doing everything cosmetic-wise on the boat. If you guys watched the last video, there was this knocking noise. Whenever I started the engine, there was this knocking noise coming from the outdrive section behind the motor. I could have swore it was U-joints. So I went ahead, I popped that bad boy off. Everything looked good, everything looked clean. There was no chipped gears. I was like, what is going on, man? So what did I do? I went on forums, I checked it out, I was reading, I did hours of research, and somebody mentioned, hey man, it's probably your throttle cable. Your throttle cable probably needs adjusted. And the reason that throttle cable needed adjusted on this boat is because this boat is about 23 years old, and all that throttle cable is a steel rope inside a conduit, and over time, that pressure of the stretching, expansion from the heat and the cold, that steel rope is gonna wear out over time. That's just how it goes. And I found a really great video online that I'll share with you guys. I'll put the link right here for you guys, and it'll also be a link in the description. And this guy does a really good job of how to adjust your shift cables on your boat. It helped me out a lot, and it fixed the whole entire issue for me. Super easy fix, and I really hope it helps you guys as well. So after the clunky noise was fixed on the boat, it was now time to tackle another big issue. That next issue is my trim would not go up. And I was like, oh man, but usually trim is a really easy fix. All you have for trim systems on a boat is a switch, go into a plug, and that plug goes to two electrical solenoids that go up and down on your trim pump. So what did I do? I busted the old multimeter out, and I did some troubleshooting, and it did turn out that my solenoid wasn't getting the signal that it needed. And it turns out the solenoid was in fact bad. So what did I do? I went on Amazon and I went ahead and ordered that bad boy. And as you can see here, this is an awesome solenoid for your boat. It's super cheap and it does the job. It's exactly what you need. Really easy to wire up. And if you guys are interested in buying that for yourself, I'll put the link down in the description for you guys. Any product I talk about in this video, the link will be in the description to help you guys out. This was a really easy fix for me. There was just two mounting bolts. I got my ratchet out. I busted that guy off. And there's about four wires. But anytime I do wiring on anything, I always bust my phone out, take a picture. That way when I go to wire it back up and I think it's all said and done, I double check my picture to make sure it's all good. And I do that on anything electrical. If it's simple, if it's complicated, it doesn't matter. I just want it to be right. The solenoid did work. I put it in, here's a new one of me installing it. And I went ahead, went up there, operated my switch, and boom. As you guys can see here, the trim is working. So now that we got the clunky noise knocked out, we got the trim knocked out, there's gotta be something else big, right? The only big electrical issue I had on this boat was my fuse box. And for some reason, on my dash, is that I would go to hit the switches. As you guys can see here, I would go to hit the switches and I would get a switch light, but none of my switches would operate anything on the boat like I said they would. What does that mean? So what did I do? I busted the multimeter out, I checked the fuses, I checked the circuit breakers, I started off with something really simple, and it turns out that my fuse box was not getting the 12 volts that it needed. It was only getting about 6 volts. So this led me to believe, maybe the main circuit breaker that's sending 12 volts to my fuse box is corroded and dirty from all the water getting in it and the weathering and just old age, right? So what did I do? I went ahead, I got some contact cleaner, I sprayed it all in there. I cycled the switch a few times, and after about the 10th time of cycling it, I was able to get 12 volts to my fuse box, and that allowed all my switches to work. Anytime that stuff happens, I'm really excited because I don't have to order parts. It's not complicated, it's a really easy fix. So I got the biggest electrical issue knocked out. My bilge was working, my bilge pump was working, my bilge blower was working, my core lights were working, but there's only one thing that wasn't working, right? And that was my navigation light. So I'm thinking, hopefully some rest in it, true, some wires or anything. So I went ahead, I did a continuity test. All right, cool. All my wires are good, that passed. The next thing I checked was the light bulb. And this was really easy, as you guys can see here on the boat. It's only 3 screws, a little casing comes off, and you got your bulb sitting in there on 2 spring-loaded contacts. So I went ahead, took that bulb out, and the filament was so small, I couldn't really tell if it was blown or not, so got the multimeter out. I read the contacts, they were getting 12 volts. I'm thinking, cool, it's just a bulb, right? I went ahead, I went on Amazon, I ordered this really cool LED bulb. I always like getting LED bulbs on these older projects because it really modernizes it up. It makes it brighter, and it's just a safety light, and we want the boat to be safe, and I want it to be bright, I want it to look good. So I went on Amazon, I ordered this bad boy for about $12, I think. Really cheap, did the job, showed up in like 2 days. And you guys can see here on the boat just how good that looks, man. I love that light. Anyways, little tiny light, but the only advice I have for you guys at home watching is that anytime you have an LED light with two contacts like that, it has to be in the correct polarity, because an LED, light emitting diode, all a diode is an electronic check valve. It allows electricity to go one way, but it doesn't let it go the other way. So if you guys put that light bulb in, that LED, and it doesn't work, just flip it around, put it in another way. And that should do the job. If it doesn't light up, you got bigger issues on your hands. Sorry, man. So now that we've covered all that, the next biggest issue on the boat is one that just drove me crazy. It's something I can't live without. That's something I need, and that is a working stereo with Bluetooth. I cannot stay in the radio, I gotta have Bluetooth. I hope you guys think the same way. If you guys have a favorite Spotify playlist you listen to, go ahead, let me know in the comments below, because I love listening to new music. So as you guys can see here, this old stereo on the boat, it was just old, it didn't have Bluetooth, it didn't work right, the speakers were blown out. So what did I do? I did what I do best, and I went ahead and I ripped that bad boy out. I got it right out, that's right. And I went online, I ordered the proper stereo, and as you guys can see here, this is a marine stereo, a boat stereo. It's waterproof, it does the job. But I also ordered a splash guard for it, which you guys can see right here. You can find these online for real cheap. I even found them at Bass Pro for pretty cheap as well. But I always like that extra protection for UV and the water. Wiring stereos in on boats isn't really that hard, and it was actually fairly easy on this boat because the wiring harness for the stereo had about a 5-inch plug, as you guys can see here. So I went ahead, I brought that plug in my house. I got all the wires stripped out. And as you guys can see, I had to create kind of my own harness because the new radio could not take the old adapter that the old radio had for the boat. So I went ahead, I brought it in my house, stripped the wires, inspected everything. It all looked good. It passed the continuity checks. Everything was looking good. I usually solder these, but for this project, I just went ahead and used butt connectors. It does the job, and stereo wiring is really easy. All the wire coloring is pretty much standard across the board. Your speaker wire is always the same color, and your power and accessory wires are usually the same color, and you can tell by the wire gauge as well. So I went ahead and I popped that bad boy back in the boat, and I hit the power button, and boom, that thing was on. I liked it, it's good, it worked. There's only one other issue. I didn't know if my wiring or the boat wiring was actually held its integrity. I didn't know if it was good on the boat. When I ordered that radio, I went ahead and I ordered a radio speaker bundle, and I thought I was getting white speakers, but I actually got black speakers. And after I put those speakers in the boat, I'm really glad I got black ones instead of white, because I really like the black. I think it looks sharp, it goes well with the boat. But here is my advice to you guys. If you guys are doing boat speakers in your boat, please order the right size, because my last boat, I ordered 6.5 inch speakers when that old boat had 6 inch speakers, and I had to cut the fiberglass to make the new speakers work, and I really didn't want to do any cutting this time, so I went ahead and I ordered the right size speakers. As soon as I got those speakers wired in, got them installed, they sounded excellent. I was super happy with it. They were loud. You could adjust the bass on them if you wanted to. They're going to do the job. So now that you guys know where the boat stands, we are very close to selling the boat, and in part 9 we are probably going to be taking the boat on the water, and I'm excited for it. I hope you guys are just as excited as me, because it's so cool taking something on the water that you worked on, you built, or you fixed. It's just a cool feeling behind it. Some of you guys probably know what I'm talking about. And that goes with cars, motorcycles, anything. Hope you guys come back next week, check out part 9, because we are going to be taking this boat on the water. Hopefully it doesn't blow up or anything crazy, and hopefully we stay safe. The boat's just about done. I think the only thing left I have to do on the boat is I got to detail the boat, and I got to get rid of, there's some overspray from the paint. I got to clean that off. So now that you guys know the status of the boat, are we almost done with the boat? Absolutely. The boat is just about done. We're going to take it out on the water. And we are going to sell it as soon as possible, because we want to get more projects for this channel, and we want to make that $100,000. And I'm so glad you guys are here with me through the process. And like I said, I love talking to you guys about it. And next week we should be taking the boat on the water, and I'm going to get some really good footage of that for you guys, because the last boat I did not get good footage on the water. I'm sorry about that, but I am going to make up for it this time. So anyways, I appreciate you guys watching. If you guys have anything to say, let me know in the comments below. Let's go ahead, hit that subscribe button. Let me know how I'm doing. I appreciate you guys watching. This is Slick Shiz. I'm Mac. Stay busy.